researchers have built a miniature electro-optical switch which can change the spin or angular momentum of a liquid form of light by applying electric fields to a semiconductor device a millionth of a meter in size. Their results reported in the journal Nature Materials demonstrate how to bridge the gap between light and electricity, which could enable the development of ever faster and smaller electronics. There is a fundamental disparity between the way in which information is processed and transmitted by current technologies. To process information, electrical charges are moved around on semiconductor chips, and to transmit it, light flashes are sent down optical fibers. Current methods of converting between electrical and optical signals are both inefficient and slow, and researchers have been searching for ways to incorporate that too. In order to make electronics faster and more powerful, more transistors need to be squeezed onto semiconductor chips. For the past 50 years, the number of transistors on a single chip has doubled every 2 years. This is known as Moore's law. However, as chips keep getting smaller, scientists now have to deal with the quantum effects associated with individual atoms and electrons, and they are looking for alternatives to the electron as the primary carrier of information in order to keep up with Moore's law and our thirst for faster, cheaper, and more powerful electronics. The University of Cambridge researchers, in collaboration with researchers from Mexico and Greece, have built a switch which utilizes a new state of matter called polariton Bose-Einstein condensate in order to mix electric and optical signals while using minuscule amounts of energy. Polariton Bose-Einstein condensates are generated by trapping light between mirrors spaced only a few millionth of a meter apart and letting it interact with thin slabs of semiconductor material, creating a half-light, half-matter mixer known as a polariton. Putting lots of polaritons in the same space can induce condensations, similar to condensation of water droplets at high humidity, and the formation of a light-matter fluid which spins clockwise or spin up, or anti-clockwise or spin down. By applying an electric field to this system, the researchers were able to control the spin of the condensate and switch it between up and down states. The polariton fluid emits light with clockwise or anti-clockwise spin, which can be sent through optical fibers for communication, converting electrical to optical signals. While the prototype device works at cryogenic temperatures, the researchers are developing other materials that can operate at room temperature so that the device may be commercialized. The other key factor for the commercialization of the device is mass production and scalability.